we are going to come and discuss something which will, a company which will tell us much more about COVID and how India is tackling it. Ashutosh Raghuvanshi, Managing Director and CEO of Fortis Healthcare, joins us to discuss the COVID situation as well as the fourth quarter earnings.
Back as promised, we're going to discuss the hospital space now that has been under a lot of pressure ever since the COVID outbreak. Occupancies have fallen substantially for the non-COVID area. Q4 FY20 was weak for Fortis Healthcare as well, as business was impacted by COVID-19, but the company has closed FY20 with a profit of over 90 crores. Ashutosh Raghuvanshi, who is the MD and CEO of Fortis Healthcare, joins us now to talk about that. Ashutosh, good morning and thanks for joining us. I wanted to understand where occupancies are at the moment, because the last time we spoke with you, you had indicated to us that occupancies have fallen substantially. Has there been any improvement at all, and what is the expectation going ahead?
Yeah, so there has been a gradual improvement in occupancy as the restrictions are getting eased up. Currently, we are hovering around 45% to 50% in various hospitals. That is in line with our expectations, and the numbers of COVID also have been increasing. We have committed about more than 1,200 beds for that, but the occupancy levels have been steadily rising.
Okay, can you give us some numbers for April? I mean, for the current quarter, that is, in terms of occupancy, in terms of you know, ability to make money at all.
Yeah, so Lata, I think, you know, the stress still remains, and you know, the occupancy levels had gone down to as low as 25% in the month of April, which now is approximately about 50%. So there has been an improvement for sure, but we had to take a lot of measures on the cost side in order to try to remain, keep our noses above water.
About the COVID test itself, what is the rule now? I thought the Ministry of Home Affairs said 2,400 rupees, but Delhi was threatening 450 rupees as the limit. Can you tell us the factual position and you know, whether you all can break even?
So various states have different price which they have set up. Delhi's central authority has recommended a price of 2,400 yesterday. And I think that is probably an average price all across the country. That is a break-even price on the direct cost side. Of course, it doesn't take care of the overheads. But I think it is a time for, you know, all enterprises, especially healthcare ones, to you know, pitch in. And so that way it is not a bad price to have.
Okay. On the diagnostic business, which was under quite a bit of pressure, what is the expectation in terms of growth going ahead?
Yeah, so the diagnostic business has sort of ramped up much faster than hospitals. So we are already at about 60 to 70% revenue levels of pre-COVID. So I think diagnostic will recover much faster than the hospitals. But hospitals probably will see a pent-up demand of procedures once the opening happens a little more.
Okay. I also wanted an update on what's happening with staff, because the last time you had indicated to us that nurses are resigning every day, there's a problem with doctors as well. Has that issue been ironed out?
Yeah, Sonia, I think as people are getting sort of getting a kind of a faith in the system, and we have also incentivized various staff, especially the frontline staff, nurses and some physicians, etc. So I think that problem is now behind us. We have taken a lot of measures, you know, to make them secure in terms of insurance and medical as well as life insurance, etc. So that problem is not so severe now. However, we have been asked to enhance capacity in certain places like Delhi, and there we will have a little bit of stress of number of people available to us. But I think we will be gradually be able to overcome it. And we have also started recruiting new nurses as well.
Okay. Good, brave people, if they are offering themselves for recruitment. It's a service both you and the team is doing. Just a final financial question, Mr. Raghuvanshi. Your net loss is 41 crores. What are your reserves? Can you withstand another quarter of losses? How many quarters of losses can you withstand?
Yeah, so right now we are in a comfortable position. We have credit lines and we also are confident of having sufficient cash flows from our internal accrual. So at least for a couple of quarters, we are quite comfortable for this financial year, I would say.
Right. We'll leave it at that, Mr. Raghuvanshi. Thank you very much indeed for joining us on your numbers and on the situation on the ground. Well, markets at the moment flat at the index level and actually strong at the mid-cap level. And we have now with us a long-time investor, watcher of India,